Guys, hello and welcome everyone back to another video. Now this is the first video since doing my collection video of my M140i, so I thought we'd start small. We're not going to do like modifications and stuff like that. We're literally just going to take the car for a first drive. I've only got like an hour or so before I have to start work, so we're going to do a quick video kind of my first drive and what my first thoughts are and all that kind of thing. But yeah, enough rambling on. If you haven't subscribed yet, make sure you do subscribe. I'm really trying to like get 50,000 subscribers this year, and I know we can do it if you guys can help out. That'd be brilliant. So leave a like rating, subscribe, and let's jump into the car, get the GoPro on the window, and have a little chat and a drive. Guys, we are now out on the road. Now I'm pretty sure you won't be able to see me just because of how bright that sun is, but hopefully in a minute it'll be alright. But anyway, so what are my first thoughts of the car? Honestly, I've only had it for, well, it's coming up to about a week now, I believe, at the time of recording this video, and I absolutely love it. It's literally just, it's so fun. Honestly, it's so fun. Now there is a few problems with it. Well, not problems with the car, there's just a minor few issues which we need to sort out, and I'll talk about that in a second. But honestly, look at this view. This is why I came down here to do this video. Look at that. I'm so lucky to live where I am, honestly. Look at that for a view. That is mental. Might have to come down here and take a few thumbnails at some point. That is so nice. If I'm gonna be honest, I haven't actually been able to put my foot down loads purely because of this issue. So, when I got this car last week, I was aware that it didn't have some decent tires on it. Now, on the front, it's got Infiniti Eco Max tires, which clearly are budgets, but it's obviously what the garage has put on to kind of pass the MOT kind of thing. It's what garages always do anyway, so I didn't expect any less. Also, on the rear, I've got the originals from 2017, the original Pilot Super Sport tyres, which if you know your tyres, you'll know that that is, that they are obviously summer tyres. So on my old car, I had Michelin Pilot Sport 4 tyres, which are very, very good tyres, way too overkill, but as I said to my mate yesterday, you can't get overkill for tyres really, because it's the only thing that keeps you connected to the road. But we're definitely going to get Pilot Sport 4s on this car. I've managed to get a good deal on them and find them pretty cheap, so we'll do that. We'll do that as a video soon. That's one of the first things I'm going to do. So obviously I've got loads of mods and stuff, but that'll be the first thing I actually pay for as such. But yeah, honestly. It's just like with this car, because it's obviously the auto, the upshifts, and like when you come off the throttle, it just farts. It sounds honestly so nice. So nice. And today the weather is amazing. I do actually start work in about an hour's time, so I've decided to come out on a quick kind of drive and do a video. So yeah, again, I'm pretty sure you won't be able to see me because just how bright it is outside. But yeah, so I've decided to come out for a quick video to kind of do my first drive. I'm probably going to repeat myself again, but first thoughts, I absolutely love this thing. Was it what I expected? I'd never test driven a 140 before. Literally, it was 100% what I expected and more. Like, this thing just keeps on pulling. Like, for a stock car, it's so good. Like, it is so good. Hear the burbles out the back there. And obviously, I drive everywhere. When I'm on Spirited drives, I drive everyone paddles. It's just so fun, like it's so engaging to kind of keep two hands on the wheel, just drop a few gears and just absolutely plant it. Oh my god, I absolutely love this thing. Honestly, this thing, obviously it's a bit thirsty, but don't worry about that. Smiles to the gallon rather than miles to the gallon, am I right? It may not come across on camera, but I absolutely love this thing. Like, I've been smiling ever since I got in this car, like from day one. Like, literally, you don't even need to be going quick. Just go along here at 20 miles an hour, drop a gear. Obviously, you won't be able to hear that on the camera, but it just sounds so nice. Another question I've been getting is, do you regret getting the auto? Because obviously I've always had manual cars. Now, honestly, I don't. Like, there's a lot, like, I would say probably
85% of 140 owners all have the auto, especially if they got an LCI car, because LCIs, I'm pretty sure, only come in auto. Well, I've never seen a manual one, because I'm pretty sure they stopped it. I love the auto. Like, in Eco Pro, it will just go into neutral, and you can just obviously get good MPG. But then if you want to have a spirited drive, you can just use the paddles, whack the gearbox into sport, and have a bit of a play. So if we drop a few gears here, because there's some decent roads, when we can obviously... And honestly though, like, I'm still short shifting because I'm not used to the power fully. Like, I'm still short shifting. Oh, honestly, this car is so good. Hopefully it comes on camera, like, my excitement. But honestly, I'm so just proud to own this thing, to be honest, at 19 years old. To be truly honest right now, this is the first time I've actually been out in my car and it's been a sunny, dry day. Whenever I've been out before, it's had greasy conditions. So have a look at my tyre temperatures in a minute. So at the minute, my tyres are only about 17 degrees, so they're not too hot. So obviously we'll try and get them a bit hotter. But I've been getting a lot of questions saying, why have you bought another 1 Series? Now, if you know your 1 Series, you know that this is not a normal 1 Series. This is obviously the top end BMW M140i, and it's completely different. Yeah, it may look similar, but it drives and feels completely different. Obviously, it's got uprated brakes. It's a completely different car. And the thing is, with my channel, it was all BMW 1 Series owners. Like, the amount of people messaged me on Instagram saying, I've got a 1 Series, you know, I've got a E87, I've got a F21, F20, whatever. So many people say, like, I've got this. And so obviously I wanted to keep loyal and I wanted to kind of keep those subscribers happy. I just love the 1 Series. I always have done. I've always wanted a 1 Series. So I want to keep it, because why change if it's not broken? You know what I mean? So I love the looks of my old car, but obviously the engine and all those kind of things, everything else, kind of let it down. And the audience isn't as big for those cars, because obviously they're not an M-Lite, this is an M-Lite, so the audience is a lot bigger, and there's a lot more things you can do to this, obviously remaps and stuff like that, but we won't be doing that for a little while. We're only going to be doing cosmetic stuff for a while, and upgrading the brakes and all that kind of thing. But yeah, I just wanted... I wanted to keep the 1 Series because I love them so much. That's all my kind of my fan base as such is all 1 Series owners. So I wanted to keep that content going. And I would have, to be honest, I could have done a bit more my old car, but it was getting to the point where I was like, why are you putting money into a car that isn't worth doing? Do you know what I mean? Bloody cyclists. Now, what are my plans with this car? Because obviously I've done a lot of the stuff on my old car. Now, with my old car, there was a few bits that I regret doing, and like stupid little modifications that I just took off, like wrapping the interior. I know not to do that again, because it was awful, and stuff like that. So I've really learned what I want to do, and I'm going to make this 1 Series, or this M140i, just a really nice condition 1 Series, and kind of make everything and just keep it clean, keep it kind of like inside anyway. I just want to make it look really stylish and nice and modern, all that kind of thing. Maybe do a few bits different to my old car. But in terms of modifications, I've got absolutely loads at home. Like, literally, I've got about 5 modification videos just at home. Like, it's pretty crazy. And that's all freebies from, like, companies who wanted to hook me up for some videos, which obviously I really do appreciate. And also, going on to companies that are supporting me at the moment. Carbon Accents are a big supporter of the channel. They have hooked me up with a few little bits of body kit for my car and some badges and all those kind of things. But also, obviously, they gave Dad his spoiler. So, obviously, that was really nice of them. So, they sent me out one of their jumpers to wear in my video if I want to. So, big shout out to them. But yeah, there's a lot of exciting things to come. And there's going to be a lot of things different. But there are going to be a few bits that I've already done my old car that I'm going to do on this car. Because, obviously, I like doing them and I want to do them again. But with the thing is, with this car, it's going to stay for quite a long time. I'm hoping to get another car down the line. Like maybe one off Copart. I'm thinking maybe like a Mini Cooper S. I think that would be quite cool. And have that as a kind of a little project car. Buy something that's like a category car and try and do it up. Because I always wanted to do that. So I think it'd be quite good time to do it once we're obviously doing the 1 Series project as well. And don't get me wrong, it's not just going to be one series kind of videos on my channel now, because obviously we've still got my dad's E92 free series to do, so we're going to do videos on that very shortly. I've decided to turn around because the roads over here and where we've just been are much better than the roads back there. So I'll turn around and we can have a bit more of a spirited drive in a second once I've had a talk. But yeah, as I said, we've still got dad's modifications to do. So that is going to be quite exciting. We've got to do his calipers and maybe put some boot struts in the car. So that is all to look forward to. So please do, if you haven't already, make sure you leave a like rating on this video, comment and subscribe, because I'd love to hear your feedback. Honestly, the amount of love and support I got on my reveal video is unreal. Like, I've gained like 300 subscribers, which is absurd for me. Like, that is crazy numbers. I've also gained like 450 comments on that video. Everyone is loving the introduction, which is awesome, because obviously I worked an awful long time on that video. So yeah, so I'm pretty glad that it kind of paid off as such. But anyway, enough of me rambling on, because we're rambling along a lot. Let's whack it into sport, put the gearbox into sport, whack it into manual, and let's go for a spirited drive. Oh mate, honestly, this car is mental. Next video is going to be my modifications video, so it'll be the first modifications video on this car. We're going to be starting small. We're not going to do anything mental for the first couple, well, for the first one at least, maybe two, but I'm just going to be doing like small little bits, and also we're going to put my my registration plate on the car as well. Obviously that's not a mod, but I'm still going to do it in the video as well. But yeah, that's all to look forward to. So that is where I'm going to wrap up the video. I really do hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure you leave a like rating, comment and subscribe, because I'd love to hear your feedback. Any comments of ideas and stuff like that, let me know. Any companies want to hook me up, let me know. But other than that, I shall catch you guys very shortly on a brand new visit. On a brand new video. All I'm going to say is 2021 is going to be a good year for the channel.